Hi, hello. Okay, so yesterday I made a video to show you my art resin project, my favorite resin, and the filming was terrible. There was so much sunlight in here, there was just, it was all glare on my work table, so I couldn't post it. So I'm going to make another one now. I'll go and get changed and get ready, but in the meantime, I want to give you a close look of this. So I made three travertine coasters with resin, and then I got these very, very cute little cheese and wine boards. It's got some backing tape on there, and resined that. So I'm gonna show you the details, and then I'll get changed and we'll do some more. So I'm going to give you a close-up of the three coasters that I made yesterday using Resi-Blast and mixing acrylic paint with resin. Here's some of the details. There's one. There's another. You can see me reflecting in it. And a third. And then this is a cheese and wine board that is just super cute. It folds up. There is the resin on the handle. And then you open it up, and this is where you would put your wine glass. And with all the cheese boards, I use a food grade cutting board oil to finish them off. I have masked off the little cheese and wine board, and I've covered everything because I don't trust myself not to drop a big blob of resin onto it, so just to be safe. And these are the coasters. They're travertine. I've masked those with duct tape, and I go around the edges with a lollipop stick to make sure it's absolutely sealed. So this is what the tile looks like. It's beautiful natural stone, and I like these rough edges. That's why I don't cover those with resin. So I'm going to mask this last one. And the colors I'm using today are Liquitex Basic Bright Aqua Green, Amsterdam Acrylic Burnt Umber, Artist Loft Unbleached Titanium, and AI Friedman's Bronze. And the bronze really does have a beautiful shine to it once it's dried. So I will finish masking this and then we'll mix up some resin. Art resin is a 1-to-1 ratio, equal parts of the resin and hardener. As always, when you're working with resin, make sure whatever your work surface you're working on is absolutely level. You'll probably need a spirit level to check this, because if it's not level, the resin's just going to run off. And all that mixing and preparation would have been a waste of time. Okay, equal parts. Art resin is a great product because it is designed for art projects. It's not toxic. You don't have to wear a respirator like you do with some of the other brands, and it's anti-yellowing. You find if you buy cheaper brands in, you know, like a hardware store, they do have a yellow tint to them, and this is just crystal clear, and it really is great. Has a great working time, approximately 30 minutes. So I'm going to put this in here. And we're going to mix it for a minimum of 3 minutes. I tend to do about 4 minutes because I want to make sure it's absolutely mixed properly, because if you don't mix it properly, it won't harden. And just before we do that, I am going to spray these surfaces with a little alcohol just to make sure all the grease is off them, grease and dust, because you want your resin to really stick. Great. 3 minutes on the clock. My watch. Make sure you go around the sides, down to the bottom. You'll see it's really cloudy right now. And after you've mixed that for 3 minutes, it will be lovely and clear with lots of air bubbles. That's why you have to be quite careful how you mix it. You're not beating an egg. But air bubbles are inevitable, and you can get them out with a torch. Once your resin is mixed, you can add it to your paint. I'm just, as you saw, using acrylic paint. And the rule of thumb is one tenth paint to resin. So one part paint, 10 parts resin, approximately. And I'm just going to add it to the cups. Whenever I work with resin, given that, you know, time is limited, you can work on an oil painting for years, but I have about half an hour to work with this. I sort of have a plan in mind. And you have to be quite flexible when you're working with resin, because it does have a mind of its own. And I know many people are afraid of using it, but practice makes perfect. And we've all made horrible mistakes. Believe me, I've made many mistakes in the beginning. And it is a beautiful medium to work with. That's the bronze. Make sure that's mixed in on the bottom. This is the burnt umber. Nice, rich, it's like chocolate. Gorgeous aqua, bright aquamarine. I was thinking of doing a yellow with these tones, but I don't know, that's boring. I have to get all my resin projects out of the way because I broke my wrist in April. I was in Turks and Caicos. And thanks to my two friends, Karen and Rebecca, they took me to hospital where it was very painfully reset just by yanking my hand. And then when I got back here to Connecticut a month later, I found out I had to have surgery and have it rebroken. And that was about a month ago. Nice big scar there. And now I found out I need another surgery because my tendon in my thumb doesn't work. Doesn't flex backwards like that. So I don't know when that surgery is going to happen. In the meantime, I will try to do as many resin projects as possible. Okay, let's begin with the chocolate. Yep, it's not much fun, physical therapy I'm having, but it's a slow process
I'm very limited in what I can do. Okay, I'm going to drizzle this over the handle. And into the wine glass holder. And when it'll spread out on its own because I've got quite a lot of resin here to work with. Then I think I'm gonna use this aquamarine. Actually, when I broke my wrist in Turks and Caicos, we were more worried about getting to the infinity bar on time for sunset, which we almost made. Now it's 24 hours later and the resin has set, and now I will apply a clear coat over the top. And the reason I do that is because I just think it gives a much more professional finish. So I've mixed up just a small amount of, I'm going to mix up a small amount of resin just so that I can go over the top. And before you resin, just take some alcohol over the top and wipe it to make sure, because this, well, firstly, you don't want any grease on your resin because that won't stick. And we used Resi-Blast, which is sort of like a silicone, and you want to make sure any residue is off the surface that you are about to resin. So we will stir this for 3 minutes. Okay, so that's the 3 minutes and it's all mixed. Remember to scrape the sides and the bottom. And I have made way too much resin here, so I will probably make some petri dishes after I've done this. So I'm just going to put it into the middle. This is also a self-leveling resin, so it'll find its own way. You don't have to worry about it being uneven. And here, I'm just going to put a tiny bit in here because I don't want to fill it up. That should do. And actually, I'm going to help this one move around. Tilt it. And tomorrow, after another 24 hours, I will do the big reveal. I wanted to show you some things that can go wrong when using Resi-Blast. You can see on this particular coaster that there are areas like here and here and here that the resin resisted the Resi-Blast. So what I did was I sanded the whole tile down and I washed it in Dial soap liquid and then rubbed alcohol over it and put a second coat of resin. And it's still, the resin resisted some Resi-Blast. So what I'm thinking is I used too much Resi-Blast. And now what I've done, I have painted some Mod Podge over those areas that resisted the resin. And I'm going to put a final coat of resin over the top, and fingers crossed, we should be okay. This is not meant to be a review on Resi-Blast, but I have to warn everybody that Resi-Blast is a great product and gives you beautiful effects in resin, but if you overuse it, it's a nightmare. I actually had to do 3 clear coats of resin over these bloody coasters. And everyone, here's my little baby. What are you doing, baby? What are you doing? Why are you sniffing around my studio? Every single time I had to sand and resand, and it just didn't work with the resin. So I think if you use it in small quantities, it's fine. But there's a huge problem with it when you use too much. So now these are the final finished ones, and I'm going to take the tape off the sides and show you the cheese board with these beautiful coasters. If you're going to work with resin, one of your go-to tools is going to have to be a Dremel, unless all you're doing is resin painting. But when you're working with coasters or cheese boards or glasses or vases, which I'm going to be doing a tutorial on, you will need to invest in one of these, because it's going to cut your work down time a lot. Also, the other thing you need to invest in is one of these, a sander, because resin, when before you put another coat on the top, does need sanding. And I have been outside sanding, and it is exhausting. So I bought this from Home Depot for, I don't know, like less than $30, and it's cut down my work time hugely, unbelievably. So I'm a perfectionist, and these coasters, you know, I use tape to seal them off, but they still have a little bit of resin that bleeds down the sides to give it a more professional touch. I use my Dremel. Whenever you're using a Dremel, be sure to wear a face mask, because the sand, oh, the dust that you get from a Dremel is so fine, you do not want that going into your lungs. To finish off the cheese board and coasters, the coasters are done. These actually only had one coat of resin with Resi-Blast, and they turned out absolutely beautiful. These little suckers were a nightmare, and these ended up having one coat of tinted resin and then 2 coats of clear resin to get rid of the flaws. And I'm not gonna diss another type of resin. I ran out of art resin and had to use a different resin to do the clear coat. The second clear coat was awful. And I know the particular resin I used for that has had great reviews, and it didn't work for me. So my art resin finally arrived, and that's what I used, and it's now perfect. This is the oils that I use for the cheese boards. You saw me sand them down. Now I need to condition them. So that's what I'm going to do right now. And there you have it. Beautiful cheese boards with resin accents, and I'm going to bring you down so you can take a closer look.
It's amazing how you can speak right to my heart. Without saying a word, you can light up the dark. Try as I may, I can never explain what I hear when you don't say a thing. The smile on your face lets me know there's a truth in your eyes, saying you'll never leave me. The touch of your hand says you'll catch me wherever I fall. You say it best when you say nothing at all.